Have you ever looked out the window of an airplane and thought, wow, how high are we exactly? It's a fleeting curiosity many of us have, but the answer is far more fascinating than you may think. In this video, we're diving into just how high planes fly, where in the skies these planes are in the atmosphere, and what altitude certain aircrafts fly at. Before we get started, make sure you like this video and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy's YouTube channel for more exciting aviation content. Let's climb! To understand how high planes fly, we first need to break down what altitude is. It's the vertical distance between an aircraft in flight and the Earth's surface. In aviation, this is usually measured in feet, meters, or flight levels. If you've ever heard a pilot say, "We're cruising at FL350, they mean 35,000 feet above sea level. Using flight levels is a standardized way for pilots and air traffic controllers to communicate clearly and avoid any confusion. Now, let's explore where planes actually fly within Earth's atmosphere. The atmosphere is divided into several layers, but three main ones significantly affect flight performance: the troposphere, the stratosphere, and low Earth orbit. Let's break these down to understand where they are and how they influence the way planes fly. The troposphere is the lowest layer of Earth's atmosphere, extending up to roughly 33,000 feet. This is where you'll find weather patterns, turbulence, and clouds. Pilots typically cruise just above this layer to enjoy smoother and clearer skies. The stratosphere lies just above the troposphere, extending from approximately 33,000 feet to 164,000 feet. It's a prime cruising zone for commercial planes and private jets, thanks to its stable, weather-free air that makes for smooth and efficient flights. Low Earth orbit begins beyond 164,000 feet, marking the boundary between the atmosphere and space. This is the realm of satellites and the International Space Station, far beyond the reach of conventional airplanes. While some experimental and rocket-powered aircraft have briefly touched this region, it's a zone reserved for space exploration. Understanding these atmospheric layers helps us see why planes fly where they do. It's about balancing performance, efficiency, and most importantly, safety. Now that we've explored the atmosphere, let's shift our focus to the types of aircraft and their typical altitude ranges. Commercial aircraft typically cruise between 30,000 and 42,000 feet. At this altitude, they can avoid most weather disturbances in the troposphere, flying above clouds and storm systems for a smoother ride. This not only ensures passenger comfort and safety, but also improves fuel efficiency by reducing drag in the thinner atmosphere. Additionally, cruising at these heights allow planes to utilize favorable wind patterns, like jet streams, which are high-altitude, fast-moving air currents that can help planes travel faster and save time and fuel. To keep passengers and crew safe at these altitudes, advanced cabin pressurization systems maintain breathable air, preventing the dangers of oxygen deprivation or hypoxia. As the saying goes, if you're lucky enough to fly private, you're lucky enough. The next type of aircraft are private jets. Private jets often cruise between 35,000 and 45,000 feet, flying higher than commercial planes to avoid air traffic and congestion. These altitudes reduce exposure to turbulence, providing a much smoother and more enjoyable experience for passengers. Flying higher also allows private jets to take advantage of reduced air resistance and more direct flight paths, optimizing both speed and fuel consumption. Their aerodynamic designs and efficient engines allow them to adjust altitudes mid-flight to handle turbulence or weather changes, all while providing passengers with a seamless, luxurious experience. Now let's shift gears to something a bit faster and more tactical: military fighter jets. These incredible machines can reach altitudes of 50,000 to 65,000 feet or more, and are designed to dominate the skies during surveillance and combat missions. Their advanced engines and sleek aerodynamic designs enable them to operate at extreme altitudes with unmatched speed and maneuverability, giving them a tactical edge in any engagement. A great example would be the F-15 Eagle, a marvel of engineering, capable of climbing to 60,000 feet. Its special variant, the Streak Eagle, nearly reached 100,000 feet during record-breaking altitude attempts, setting 8 time-to-climb records in just 2 weeks. High-altitude aircraft like the Lockheed U-2 and NASA's ER-2 push boundaries, soaring beyond 70,000 feet to perform extraordinary missions. These high-altitude aircraft handle tasks ranging from military reconnaissance to climate research. Their long, glider-like wings excel in thin air, maximizing lift and fuel efficiency for extended flights. Equipped with advanced cameras and sensors, these planes collect vital data while avoiding air traffic entirely. Pilots wear pressurized suits to withstand extreme conditions, ensuring safety during these high-altitude explorations. Let's bring things down a notch to the realm of turboprop planes. Operating between 20,000 and 30,000 feet, turboprops strike a balance between speed and efficiency. Their hybrid jet and propeller engines make them ideal for regional flights, short-haul routes, and cargo transportation. Flying at these altitudes minimizes turbulence while optimizing fuel consumption, making them versatile workhorses of the sky. Next, let's explore small planes and general aviation aircraft. These smaller planes, like the Cessna Skyhawk, typically operate between 3,000 and 15,000 feet. Their altitudes depend on factors like mission type, weather, and air traffic regulations. These planes are often used for pilot training, personal travel, and recreational flying, with lower cruising altitudes offering stunning aerial views for scenic flights. While they steer clear of high-altitude winds, they are more exposed to weather changes like rain and wind gusts. Unlike larger planes, general aviation aircraft usually lack advanced pressurization systems, relying on natural airflow for ventilation, making them unique and versatile in the skies. Epic Flight Academy utilizes a fleet of Cessna 172s and Piper PA-44 Seminoles for flight training, perfect for Epic's roughly 170 daily flights across all of our campuses. For our seventh type, ultralight aircraft and gliders bring a different kind of thrill to aviation. Operating between 10,000 and 15,000 feet, these lightweight flyers rely on nature's forces to stay aloft. Gliders use long, streamlined wings to ride thermals and updrafts, gaining altitude without an engine. Pilots must masterfully navigate rising air currents from sun-heated surfaces to extend their flights. Ultralight aircraft, on the other hand, are small, simple planes used for recreation and training. Due to their lightweight construction, they are more susceptible to wind shifts and weather changes, requiring careful planning and skill. Both ultralights and gliders embrace the art of pure, unpowered flight, offering a unique connection to the skies. Finally, we come to helicopters, the versatile masters of vertical flight. Typically operating between 2,000 and 10,000 feet, helicopters excel at low-altitude missions where precision and maneuverability are key. Their ability to take off and land vertically, even in confined spaces, make them indispensable for search and rescue, law enforcement, and medical evacuation. Unlike airplanes, helicopters can access remote areas without needing runways. This low-altitude flying, however, exposes them to wind shifts and weather changes, requiring constant adjustments by skilled pilots. While their range is limited compared to fixed-wing aircraft, helicopters' unmatched control and adaptability allow them to perform critical tasks in environments where no other aircraft can. Aircraft altitude directly affects aircraft performance, climb rate, and cruise performance. It's important to understand these key concepts. Air density decreases with altitude, reducing lift and engine efficiency, which is why jet engines are optimized to perform efficiently in thinner air at high altitudes. Aerodynamics at high altitudes reduce drag, allowing planes to maintain high speeds with minimal fuel consumption, thanks to the carefully designed shape of their wings and fuselage. Surface ceilings are the maximum height where a plane can maintain steady flight. The maximum altitude, or absolute ceiling, is the highest point an aircraft can reach under its own power, where thin air limits engine performance and aerodynamic lift, making sustained flight impossible. Density altitude measures air density compared to standard conditions, affecting climb rate and cruising performance. High-density altitudes, often found in mountainous regions, make takeoffs and landings more challenging. At high altitudes, the external air pressure is too low to sustain human life. For this reason, aircraft cabins are pressurized. Modern jets maintain an internal cabin pressure equivalent to an altitude of 6,000 to 8,000 feet above sea level. Cabin pressurization prevents hypoxia, a condition where passengers and crew experience oxygen deficiency, causing dizziness or unconsciousness. Aircraft altitude limitations depend on factors like engine capability, aerodynamic design, and passenger safety. Supersonic jets, such as the Concorde, operate at altitudes of 50,000 to 60,000 feet to reduce drag and noise, while subsonic jets cruise at 30,000 to 42,000 feet to balance fuel efficiency and comfort. Wind speeds and jet streams are crucial at these heights, helping pilots reduce travel time and fuel consumption when favorable, but slowing flights during headwinds. These factors influence long-haul and short-haul flights, as longer routes aim for higher altitudes to take advantage of strong tailwinds, while short routes prioritize quick climbs and descents to save time. The flight ceiling represents the maximum altitude an aircraft can sustain level flight, while the service ceiling is slightly lower to ensure a safety margin. At higher altitudes, thinner air reduces climb rates, while some rocket-powered aircraft even reaching into the stratosphere, far beyond conventional planes. Climbing altitude refers to the transition from takeoff to cruising altitude, with climb rates measured in feet per minute. Factors like aircraft type, weight, weather conditions, and air density play a significant role. Smaller planes climb slower and to lower altitudes compared to jets, while heavier planes require more thrust to ascend. Weather elements like turbulence and wind shear affect ascent performance, and in high-density altitudes, thinner air challenges engine and wing efficiency, making climbs more demanding. At this point in the video, you must be wondering, what is the highest any plane has ever flown? The highest altitude ever reached by an aircraft is 123,523 feet, achieved by Russian pilot Alexander Fedotov in a modified MiG-25 Foxbat on August 31, 1977. Fedotov reached this record altitude during a near vertical climb. From the troposphere to the stratosphere, and from small planes to supersonic jets, the altitudes aircraft reach tells a fascinating story of the ingenuity of human engineering, adaptability, and purpose. Each type of aircraft operates within its unique altitude range, optimized for performance, efficiency, and mission requirements. Understanding these altitudes and what aircraft can fly where reveals how aviation has mastery over the skies, whether it's for commercial travel, military missions, or recreational flying. Thank you for joining us on this high-flying journey. Make sure you like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more aviation insights from Epic Flight Academy.